Hello guys, Ivirex here. We're going to build the best cooling pad for gaming laptops. This laptop cooler isn't the cheaper one in the market. Build this beast costs about 93 USD with two fan configurations and 71 USD with one fan. But surely you will get the best and more efficient one. It is important that you know the difference between static pressure and airflow. I strongly suggest you search in YouTube that subject to understand why I chose those fans in specific. This is my MSI GT80 Titan laptop. Most gaming laptops have a similar ventilation mesh under. This laptop in special has a very good cooling system, but with our custom cooler, the fans run enormously quieter, since they don't have to reach those noisy high RPM levels. The problem with the most laptop coolers, it is their weak fans. This 3 right here comes with a Cooler Master NotePal U3 Plus. They are one perfect example of the limitations that every cooling pad has right now. The problem is the USB port. They can only supply 5 volts. That's why we're going to use a little converter from 5 to 12 volts. But then at 12 volts, one USB 2.0 port can deliver 0.2 amps, which is enough for only one of our fans. One USB 3.0 port at 12 volts can deliver 0.375 amps, which can handle up to two of our choices fan. Those are the Noctua NF-A14, specially designed for high static pressure, which is exactly what we want in this application. This is the Cooler Master NotePal U3 Plus. We will use just the aluminum body for this project. And finally, this little guy right here, it is the converter. This model in specific has two different voltage outputs, so you can change between 9 or 12 volts and have two different fan speeds. You can see the little switch right here, easy to use. The USB connector and the DC standard connector. This right here is the Noctua out of the box. It comes with a 4-pin fan connector. The plastic shell has some symbols on it so you can identify the positive and the negative. Each fan comes with one 4-pin splitter. We're going to use just one of these. You'll need to cut the DC connector out of the converter and strip the cable. I just used my knife, so sorry about the poor quality. It should look a lot better than this one, but you'd get the idea. Now you will need to test if everything is working okay. I used a battery bank for convenience, as you can see here, but you can use your laptop if you don't have one battery pack available. In this case, the black cable goes with the black and the red goes with the yellow. Now we're using the splitter cable to test two fans at the same time. As you can see here, everything works just great. In this final test, I'm using my laptop USB 3.0 port, as you can see here, to power up the fans. Everything's working great. Now you have to cut one 4-pin female connector and join the cables as mentioned before. I used here the same coating that comes with the cable to cover up the join. This is one example of the coating that I get from this cable right here. Alright, it is time to install the fans. I already have one here in place. Of course, you can place them wherever you want. The holes in the aluminum mesh fits perfectly with the rubber mounting system, so that's why I used them instead of the screws. However, I was only able to align three of them, but at the end worked perfectly with no vibrations. This is how it looks with two fans. And the final thing, it is to do some cables management, and you're already set. I recommend to stay below 1500 RPM fans to get almost complete silence at full speed. But if you want, you can use any 12 volts fan. Just make sure you check the amps consumption first, and you'll be okay. And that's it, guys. Hope you guys like it. I put the links of the items in the description. See you soon, my friends. Bye bye.